So, welcome everybody. This is the beginning of the course on ambient intelligence that you chose in your set of courses from among the long list of optional courses. I hope you chose this because you will be in love with this topic and with the work that we are going to do. So I'm spending this first hour in trying to describe you the main organization of the course, the topics, and what will happen next during this semester. A lot will happen. I can guarantee you that a lot will happen in this semester. And first of all, the single most important piece of information that you need to write down, and the only one that you need to remember, is the link to this website, bit.ly/polita.mi. That is the website I already, it's not a secret, I already told you in the mail. That is the website where you will find all the material concerning this course. So all the slides, all the links, all the documentation, and so on. And from that, we will give you additional information, additional resources as we go. And so this is the look. So now probably it's too complex to open a web page, but okay. So before going to the boring part of telling you the books, the timetable, and so on, I wanted to give you a flash with pictures of what is specific about this course. So what do we see when we think about the ambient intelligence course, which is not just additional topics that you have to study and to know on the day of the exam. It's a path that we are going to walk together, and this path is made of projects. The project that we will do together, you and us, we will start thinking about these projects, we will develop them, you mainly will develop them, we will try to help you and tutor you in developing these projects, and at the end of the course you will have something real, running, working, prototype of the project that you have chosen. So all the time that we spend in the course is devoted towards helping you in realizing your own project during the course. Of course, with a lot of constraints, with a lot of methodologies that we need to follow. But in the end, the only thing that is important is that you can reach the end of the course and develop your project. And you develop your project with teams. I already mentioned to you that we would like you to split in groups of four people. And each group will form a team that will develop their own projects. So if we have probably 18 or something like that teams based on the number of people, we'll have 18 different projects that will start at the beginning of the course and will be developed throughout the course. So it's a project work, it's a team work, and it's playing with technology. Yeah, we have some pictures from last year's projects that just give you some flash about the white of possible options that were developed during the project. So every project will choose different technologies depending on what they want to achieve. Something will be more software, something will be more hardware, in some cases you need to create your own device, in some cases you need to interface with an existing device, and so on. So these will be your choices during the development of the projects, learning to play and select different kinds of technology. This is not a technology course where we learn one specific technology very well. This is an integration, it's a system course. When we define our goal, the functionality that we want, and then we pick the technologies that are more suitable for that. The course is tools. This is a list, I think it's not complete, but it's a list of the technologies, tools, libraries, languages, and so on, that we will all use during the course. So if you know nothing about any of this, don't worry, in 3 months you will know a lot about each of these. And because there are different pieces of the puzzle that we need to put together in order to have the project working. Did I scare you?
Yes.
There's also a good size on it. You know, you surely know that at the end of the course, we have the exam, okay? But after the exam, we are every year organizing a public event. We call that the showcase, the ambient intelligence showcase, where you can, at that point, you will have passed the exam. It will be the pain and the suffering will just be a memory. And you have your project, and we will help you to show your project to the world. So we are organizing a large event with you know, at least 200 people that came last year to come and see your projects, and you can show them. So you will learn to manage a project, to realize a prototype, a demo, and to show it to people that can be interested in your work. They can be interested, they can in the work, just out of curiosity. They can be interested in your ideas, because maybe these people come from companies that want to, find fresh ideas for new type of products, or they can be interested in you as persons, just for hiring you. Companies are always hungry for smart people to hire. So that's one chance that we have to show your project. Of GM Intelligence is collaboration with the industries. We have some, these are the ones that sponsored last year's edition of the course. This one we are trying again to put together a set of sponsor companies that will help us to have the equipment that we need, will help us to cover the cost of the showcase, and most importantly, they will sponsor the prizes that the three best projects in the showcase will win. So there will be very interesting prizes for you, or for some of you at least. And during the course, you will have one chance to meet with the companies and talk about your projects and start creating some links and some relationships. Okay, we are aware that most of you want to continue with studying the master, but some of you maybe want to do the master in parallel with some work activity, or some want to stop and open a startup or a company. And so that's why in the last year, we are trying to help you in finding some link with some companies in the information technology sector here in this area. And ambient intelligence outreach, these are some pictures of people that of activities that came after the showcase, after the project. So students went to public events outside the Polytechnic, outside Torino, outside our organization, to present their projects in a startup fair last year. People presented a poster doing a thesis for a new kind of work. So what follows the course may be some of you can still work on your project and try to present it, and maybe some win some prizes or whatever. So this is the context. It's ambitious. We want to make you, known. We want to make you develop something challenging, something smart, and be able to show it. Of course, there's a long path. It's 60 hours. Well, it's more than 60 hours. 60 hours on the calendar, but you don't count them, because otherwise you will get scared at the end. Okay, so this is the general context. Let's say in more detail what are the different aspects that you need to know from the organization point of view. So, as I mentioned, the goal of the course, the real goal is to develop projects and become the smartest person in the world. But limiting to the course and to the exam, the topic of the course is ambient intelligence. So you could develop projects about everything, but in this course, the topic we selected is ambient intelligence, meaning making some ambients, some environments, smarter. Smart, adding some smart behavior to an existing environment. And what does it mean to have a smart environment? It means an environment that improves their interaction with the people that are there. So not just something that is more energy saving or more automated. Something where people can interact better, a room, a house, a car that understands people, understands their users, can anticipate their needs, can propose something new, can find a new solution, and so on. We'll get into more detail about this definition in the next class on Thursday. So the idea at the end is to create a small corner, because we will have only a small project, not a whole house, but a corner that will exhibit this kind of smart behaviors. And as far as technology is concerned, we don't want to start from the technology. So, I'm a fan of Arduino, I want to use Arduino at any cost. No, that's not the approach that we want. We have this kind of board from this company, we will use that board. You cannot decide on technology as the first step. What we want to do is to start from the features of the system, what the system will do, what the system will do with the users, and only after that, choose the best technologies for that. So it's quite a different approach from what you had in the previous course. In the previous courses, you learned each technology by itself, and you never questioned why. You are learning this technology and that technology and so on. Now we are putting ourselves on the other side of the table and say, okay, this is what we want to do. We learned a lot of technology. We can learn many more. Which ones are best suited for our project? Software technology, programming technology, but also hardware technologies. So devices that you can interface with, you can interact with. Another aspect that we want to stress in this course is not doing everything yourself. You don't need to create everything down to the transistor level. Okay? If there is something already working, as a first step, try to find something that is already there, it's working, and you can integrate it, you can interface with that, you can reuse something that is already existing. So it's important being able to create your own building block, but it's equally important to be able to reuse existing devices on the market that are maybe available in the lab, or you can buy them, and you can use them to shorten your development time. You don't need to own every single bit of it. You need to own the system behavior, not the system components. And at the end, we need to have a really working system, which is different from having an exam text that will compile and more or less will run correctly once at the exam day or something like that. So you will find that a lot of debugging, a lot of fitting needs to be done at the end in order to have the system ready to be shown, ready to be demoed, ready to be brought elsewhere and be assembled and be running correctly. And also, you need to work together as a team and try to exploit the work of everybody. And we know it's always difficult to work with different people, with teams of different people, but it's all part of the work of the engineer. This list of things is just we are trying to play as engineers in this course. In the topic of embedded intelligence, this is a very short definition, but we'll analyze it better in the next class, as I said. An embedded intelligence system that we want to build is a digital environment that supports people in their daily lives. So something that supports people while they are doing their job, while they are living, while they are moving, while they're playing, or whatever. Proactively, but there are two adverbs here that change or make the things more complex. Proactively, but sensibly. Proactively means that the system should not wait for the user commands or for the user inputs. If I have a remote control and I use it to change the channel of my TV, it's something that will support me in my daily life. I don't need to walk to the TV to change the channel. Okay, it's something supporting me. But something that reacts, it's a reactive system, reacts to my command. A smart system should know in advance, should propose me something, should not wait for my specific input to do something. Because otherwise, we are talking about automation and not intelligence. We are trying to use automation to create intelligence, not just automate stuff. So the system should be able to know and to decide and to propose something proactively, so before we want it, but sensibly, because it's very easy for a system to propose or to imagine doing something which is completely crazy or stupid from the user point of view. So you should, the system should be proactive, but should not get into the user's way, should not create situations in which the users will be, will feel something, some difficulty. A very stupid example, if I have an energy saving device, probably one of the goals, the proactive goal of the system is to switch off the lights. But I wouldn't want to live in a house when that, when I switch the light on, the system will switch it off because it wants to save energy. So it will be a proactive, intelligent behavior. It has a goal. It will save me energy. But in that moment, it's not sensible. So we need to find this kind of system, which is not easy, to balance the intelligence of the system with the desires of the users. And doing that, we need to use sensors, we need to use actuators, we need to interface with the environment and with the devices that we have there. As I said, next class will be more on this topic. And actually, what we are creating is a bunch of technology that interfaces with the users and with the environment. The environment may be a room, a car, your house, a corridor, or an open space, or whatever you want, okay? So in the environment, we have different types of devices that are in different points of the environment, and the environment is populated with users. So we create a system here in the middle that will interact with the devices, will interact with the user, and will deliver some meaningful or smart application for the user, some smart features, some smart functionalities that the users will want. Okay? So this is the general picture. Of course, we need to learn how to interface with the devices, how to communicate with them, and how to manage the data that we get in order to take some decision. So we need to program the intelligent system. So actually, for reaching this goal, we have these main topics that will be developed during the course. We'll start by defining what we mean as an ambient intelligent system, the type of applications, the type of system that we build, and so on, trying to understand better which is the characteristic and the architecture of this kind of ambient intelligent systems. We will learn a design methodology that will start from features and functionality and will not start from technology. The technology will only be at the end. I will ask you many, many times, don't talk me about technology yet, okay, because we need to learn to separate the features from the implementation, the functionality requirements from the implementation. We learn to use different technologies that are used usually in this kind of embedded distributed systems, so Linux boards, hardware boards, the Python language, and so on, web application, gateways, and so on, and some automation technologies that are already existing, over-the-shelf devices that we have in the lab. We'll show you what we have in the lab that you will learn to interface with, and you can use it in your project if you know, if you want, if it's useful for your project. And so actually, we are trying to mix the practical work, so creating the project, with some theory about explaining, learning new things, and the technology about learning new devices, new languages, new libraries that can be used into the project. Okay, I think this more or less, this slide is already covered. Yes. Okay, so this is the topics that we want to cover. How do we do that? So first of all, we are a team of three teachers. The first is me, myself, Fulvio Corno, and the other two are hiding there in the back. Those two people standing there, okay, memorize their faces. They are Luigi on the right, on my right, and Theo on my left. And we will show up here, or they will show up here during the class, and we will show up in the labs during the week in this 60 hours of this course. Okay, so this is a team of three. We'll try all of them to support you when you have questions and so on. We'll try to split our the different topics, so you will see us around this table several times. About the schedule, we have these 2 days, Monday and Thursday. Thursday will always be in this room, and the Monday, usually we have 1 hour at 4:00. That will be in the lab called La Dispe. Does everybody know where the La Dispe is? Yes? Okay. So we have the lab there, and usually we move into this room at 5:30. In some cases, 50% of the cases, something like that, we will stay in the lab also in the second hour. Okay. But the first hour we will also be in the lab. In some cases we'll do the lab exercise and then move to the class to do some, let's say, more theoretical topic. And in other cases we will stay there to do a longer exercise in the lab. It depends week by week. We have a flexible schedule, okay, where we change the number of hours that we have in class and the number of hours we have in the lab depending on the week. So what you are seeing, this is an estimate. You'll find the full log of classes on the website that I couldn't open before thanks to PowerPoint. But we already have the preview of all the classes until the end of June, the middle of June. Okay, so you can see every week something will be different. And as a general rule, as time goes by, the number of class hours decreases. So at the beginning, we will have full weeks of class and exercise. We will have 4 slots, 6 hours per week. The average is 4.5 hours because it's a 6-credit course. So in the average will be 3 slots per week. But we will do 4 slots at the beginning and then drop to 3, then drop to 2. And in the last month, we will have no more classes, no more labs, only time for you in the lab to complete your project. So as time goes by, we will step back, disappear, stop talking to you, and start working with you or start supporting you while you're doing your work in the lab. So we have the first half of the course in which we try to give you the information that you need to create the project, while in parallel you start developing the idea and the specification of the project. The first half of the course, more or less up to here, seven weeks. In the second half of the course, there will be little or no more additional theoretical topics, and all the time will be devoted to your project, to developing it, in the hope of having the project finished and completed by the end of the course. Now, this is a bit a different organization, but from the usual standard week, but we find it we could follow your work better. The lab is, of course, the important part of the course, because it's there where you learn how to use the technologies that you will need to exploit for building your project. And we try to use the lab hours in partly for proposing you some exercises to learn different technology, Python, web application, interfacing, and so on. So we give you the classical lab exercise where we have the text, and we provide the text, and you need to implement something. But half of the time is what we call supervised work group. So a lab time in which we are there, we can help if you have need, but you don't have a special assignment. You just have time for working on your project and asking questions if you need. The lab is also open, the lab space is also open in other hours. So if you want to go there and continue your project, of course we will not be there, but the lab is there and the devices are there for you to use. Okay. And of course, working the group on your group project. Okay, so a couple of weeks ago, no, more than that, I sent you a questionnaire that many of you have completed, not all of you, asking some background information about you just to start preparing the course and understanding what kind of people we have this year. Because since it's an elective course, every year we have a different mix of people. So it turns out that We have the majority of the students here are from Ingegneria Informatica, or computer science, depending on what you are following, the Italian or the English version. The second largest group is people from electronic engineering. There are some mechanical engineers, aeronautic engineers. This should be electronic and communication, something like that, electrotechnica. And some individuals that are from different courses. So most of you, except maybe these 10 people here, all the others are mainly from the ICT sector. So you should already have some kind of background in programming, in computer science, and so on. And the others are more from the industrial sectors. So my suggestion is try to merge. For these people who don't have a good background in programming, try to merge with other groups. No, don't make the group of the mechanical students, because otherwise you will not be able to finish the project. Okay. So another question was, what is your self-evaluation about different types of skills? So the scale was 1 is not at all, and 5 is very good. And so programming in general is 3 and 4. So you feel quite confident about programming, good. And then about the specific technologies or techniques used for programming, web architecture is something, a split between nothing at all or I know something. And all the rest is mainly 1, 1, 1. So you didn't touch in your career, in your study, most of you, of course, we are talking about the majority numbers, any of these topics. That we will try to touch, of course, here. And especially source control and software requirements that are a strong part of the course. And about programming languages, we see that the only chart where the maximum is on the right of the picture is the C language. Of course, you should do every one of you should already have passed after the first year. And for all the other languages, we see a very strong presence on the 1 column, so it means that it's nearly totally unknown to most of you. I'm not afraid by that, I'm not worried. It turns out that you will get there. This is a chart that a statistic that we made from the previous projects of 2014 and 15, where the initial questionnaire was very similar to yours, okay? So people who didn't know these technologies, these are the main categories that we shown before, and these are the languages, and you see that the pattern is the same. It's not from you, it's from previous students. But by analyzing the projects, the final projects, we saw that most of the projects actually at the end used this kind of technologies. So it means that it's possible to learn them in the framework of a semester, at least to the level of depth that we need to create a working project. So don't be afraid. Don't be scared about what you don't know. This is a nice part of learning. Resources. I already mentioned, and I try to open, actually, if this time I'm more successful, the website. It's a complex task. Okay, where you will find you find all the information, especially the lecture slides and so on. And as I mentioned, the schedule of the future lectures. And at the same time, so there will be all the written material, I would say. And as you see, I'm recording this class, and all the classes, all the lectures that we do in this classroom, of course, will be available on the Portale della Didattica, in your page, so you can see the classes there. Let's see. Well, okay, I know what happened. They didn't configure the proxy correctly on this machine because they can navigate internally but not externally. Maybe. Okay. And in addition to the website, we have also other resources like the Facebook group that we will use to give you maybe some notice, some links. You can also use it for asking questions, for sharing maybe some information, for discussing. It's an open group among ourselves. So it's nothing formal, it's nothing official. But if you are on Facebook, you are encouraged to join. We will also upload the classes on YouTube just to make it easier to follow them instead of logging every time into the portal. At the beginning of the course, we need to collaborate on Google Drive for helping us with the definition of the projects. And most of the work, most of the programming work will be done on the GitHub platform, which is a source control platform where we can work collaboratively on a source, on one or more source code projects. And we will learn to use that. You are required to do that. And we suggest actually doing the development using GitHub and not just exchanging files among computers on USB keys or some prehistoric means of sharing information. Okay, so this the working on this collaborative source control systems is now standard, and we will use it in the course. So this is the page that hopefully will load after. Unfortunately, we don't have any textbook for the course because most of the information that we know that you need to learn is maybe on the classes, on the video lectures, and most of it is on the internet. It's available because we are actually touching a lot of open and standard technologies. On the website there are some suggestions for some books, but they are actually not really needed. It's more important to be able to search and find for the information that you need, because you, apart from some standard and basic starting knowledge, after a while, you will find that every project needs to learn or needs to work on specific different technologies, specific different aspects. So every project will have to learn on their own different stuff, different knowledge, OK? Oh, I mentioned the exam. And how did it work? So actually, all the course is practical, is goal-oriented, and it's oriented to the goal of having your project finished and terminated and working. And during the semester, having a successful project doesn't mean being able to program very well. Yes, it's needed. Of course, it's a project that has a very strong software component. Okay. But you will find that you will need a lot of other skills. You need to be able to work together. You need probably to be able to work with students from other countries, so work in English and not in your native language. You need to be able to follow some deadlines, some timings that we are asking you to follow, as it's normal in any industrial project or in any real projects, and to do the right thing at the right time. So not to anticipate too much, given design choices, when it's too early to learn, and so on. So it's a mix of skills that you need to develop during the project, then during the course, and that will all finalize in the day of the exam. And we try to make the exam also very focused. So we are not asking to you for an oral examination or a written examination, and so on, but it's something that will be an exam in the lab. So the day of the exam, you will come in the lab and you will tell us about your project. And so that it should be possible for you to close everything about this course, so all the exam in the summer session, even because many of you are from abroad, so they will come, they will go back to their universities or to their countries, and so it would be difficult maybe to give the exam later or whatever. So everything. It's organized so that most of you can attempt the exam in the June or July sessions. So the exam is the evaluation of the group work. And this evaluation is composed of two parts. First is the first half is the documentation that you created during the course. I will show the deadlines, the document that you need to provide. And on the exam day, we will revise all your documentation, and we will evaluate that. And the other half of the exam is the presentation of the project. The presentation is composed of a PowerPoint presentation or an oral presentation by the group, and followed by a demo, a practical demo, demonstration of the project, and a discussion, a question where we can ask more details about that. So half of the score of your exam is during the course, is material that you produce during the course, and half of the scores on your exam is the material that you present on the day of the exam, actually. And the work groups, so for the exam, the exam will be presented in groups, usually. So usually the four people that are working in the same team will give the exam the same day. Usually it's not necessary, so we can arrange for that. These groups should be formed at the beginning of the course. We will give you a deadline for the group composition. And each group, after the group is defined, will propose a topic that will be the title, the topic of the project that we work on. So we have the first month, more or less, of work, the first 3 or 4 weeks, that are for the definition of the groups and the topics. We will iterate it on the topics, probably, because maybe you have an idea, we want to make it better, we want to refine it, we want to make it simpler. So we need to interact on that. We will have a lot of discussion at the beginning, the first weeks, trying to define an idea which is suitable for the exam, which is suitable for an ambient intelligence system. So this is the process that we will follow. So it's not actually today, it's on Thursday. We will reason about the theme of the year. We know that in ambient intelligence, every year we choose a different theme, a different wide topic to which every project should refer. And this year, I mentioned that in the mail, the topic will be sustainability. So on Thursday, we will try to reason, to think about what kind of projects you can imagine in this broad topic. Now, the topic is broad enough, the theme is broad enough to generate 20 or so different projects. So start thinking about non-trivial things, thinking about corner cases, trying to think new things, new ideas, and so on. On Thursday, we'll discuss about that. And by the 22nd of March, you should submit the group composition, so the four people that will compose the group, and some initial ideas. So we are this group, and we want to do this project. Of course, from now to the 22nd, we will have a lot of discussion in the corridor before or after the classes and so on, also to help you in the composition of the group and in finalizing the idea. Okay? But at that day, we will have a document with the list of groups and the list of ideas. The red blocks are work that are needed from your side, are your deadlines. Okay? The blue blocks are our work from our side. So after you compose the group, you need to submit them on the 23rd, which is a class, which is a Thursday here in the class. We will have a discussion about the groups. So we will show together, we will analyze together the idea. We'll say, okay, this is a good idea. Okay, go ahead. You can start your project. This is a weak idea. We can improve that in this way. This is a bad idea. There's nothing to be said. Try to think about something else. Okay, more or less. So we'll have 2 or 3 hours of discussion about different groups. Some group will be given the green light and can go on. And for other group, we will try to help them on the 23rd. After the discussion, for all the groups that are being, you know, green-lighted or yellow-lighted, they can define the final group composition. So that will be the finalization of the group composition and of the topic of the group. At that point, we will create the repositories on GitHub for you to start working, to start uploading your work. Okay? Probably there will be some group that will not match this deadline, those ones whose idea was too weak, and of course we will do this later. But we try to stay with these deadlines. And 1 week after that, so at the beginning of April, the group composition, the idea, the vision, we see that needs to be uploaded to the website. So you need to create a website on GitHub, on the repository that we created on GitHub, and that will be the D1 deliverable number one. There are three official deliverables during the course that are the three documents that will be evaluated during the exam. So the first deliverable, 1st of April, is the website with the vision about the project. Of course, we will discuss in class about what is needed in this deliverable, okay? We will give you a structure, the guidelines of what we are asking. 1st of April. After that, we will give you, and the pattern is always the same. You need to submit something, and right after that, we give you some feedback about what you have just submitted. So this is probably a Sunday or a Saturday, and this is a Monday in the lab. We'll have some feedback, so we'll come group by group and give you some comments about the kind of deliverable that you uploaded on the website, so that you can improve it. So we are not grading it now. We will grade it on June, when you come for the exam. Now we are helping you to make it better during the course. Okay, so until during the course, we are friends with you. At the exam, we will be less friends, okay? And we will be on the other side. So we can give you hints, suggestions, requirements on how to modify or whether it's good or not what you just uploaded. And this is for every deliverable. The second step is about requirements. It will happen a month later, more or less, but we have Easter in the middle. So where from the initial vision of the project, you will be required to write a detailed list of requirements, what things the system will do. Okay? Again, we will explain in the class what kind of document you need to prepare, and you need to submit it where? Always on the same website. So we are creating a website that grows during the project, during the semester. Okay? You upload more information to it. And guess what? After that, we will have a session in the lab of feedback about the content deliverable to group by group, individual feedback. Third step, third deliverable, the architecture of the system. So up to deliverable 2, we just discussed about what the system will do. In deliverable 3, we will also discuss about how the system will work. What are the components? What is the architecture? What are the technologies that we use, and so on. So you are not allowed to mention any technology before this deliverable. You should think about the project, think about the requirement without even mentioning any technology. It's not easy. But we need to separate the requirements from the implementation. And the implementation, the design of the implementation, will start only here. And again, we have a feedback session on that. At that point, we should have everything defined. We know where we want to go, the vision. We know what the system will do, the requirement. We know how the system will work, the architecture. So you are ready, we are ready to give a final presentation about your proposed project. This is the turning point of the course. In this day, the 25th of May, you finish thinking about the project and you start working on the project. And this turning point will be a public event here in the classroom. We will invite some companies to come and listen to your presentation and ask questions, give suggestions to you. So each group will make a 5-minute presentation of their project. We will give you, of course, some hints about how to do that. And the companies that are working with us in the course, will listen to you, will fill a questionnaire with score, will tell you how your presentation went, how your idea was, and maybe they can interact with you. So this is an important checkpoint where you can get feedback not just from us, from teachers, but also from external experts. And after this day, the project is fixed, you have your presentation, you define what you want to achieve, and you are mostly on your own in developing it. So from these days, most of the work will be in work group, supervised or free work group, where you can work on, on your project. You see that actually the teaching activity in class will be finished by this date. So you have 3 or 4 weeks of time just for finishing the work without any classes to attend in this course and so on. Of course, even if the classes are over in this part, you always have access to the lab. You can always ask questions to us. You can always go to the LaVISP to work on your system. So we don't disappear. We just stop stealing your time in asking you to come to the this classroom. And sooner or later, after that, you can present your work at the exam. The date is already out. There are, as usual, 2 days in the summer and 1 date in September. And you present your work. During the exam, we give a general score, which is composed of the examination or the evaluation of the 1, the 2, and the 3, and plus a presentation video that you will add on the website. So this is half of the scores, 16 points, and the other 16 points are on the presentation of the day, on what you do there. And plus, we have also some adjustment for the individual contribution to the project. So usually, by default, all the 4 members of the group will get the same score. But if we see that somebody worked more, or probably somebody worked less, we will, of course, adjust the scores, individual scores, and not the, say, just get the membership score of the group. OK. And this finishes the exam. But then, all the people who pass the exam in July or in September are invited, are strongly invited, to come and present their work on the showcase. That it's optional, it's out of the course. After the exam, okay, we are no longer bound by any constraint, but we will continue to get in touch with you and to invite you to this showcase. The tentative date is the 3rd of October. It's in the first week of classes in the next year. So even people who are not living in Torino will already be back because the classes will start on the 2nd of October. So people will already be here, both you for presenting and other students, the younger ones, that want to come and follow and see your work. At the end, we will be all destroyed. It's a very demanding path to follow. You see that the deadlines are very close. You need to present a deadline, and 2 days after, we need to already give the feedback, and the next week, you already have the next deadline, and so on. So it's something that will keep every one of us, you as students and us teachers, very engaged. And at the end, we will be exhausted, by sure, for sure. But I think it's worth the effort. OK, this is what we'll decide about the exam. And OK, so we started from the end, from the exam. But of course, the starting point is start thinking about the groups. So the general rule, we would like to have groups of 4 people as much as possible. Of course, the number of students is not it's not always multiple of 4. So in some cases, we can accept a group of 3 people. And I would say possibly we meet skills. So the group, the project is multidisciplinary. It's something about hardware, something about software, something about interfaces. And there's also some websites, some video to do, some communication about that. So you will need different skills. And if you have people with different skills in the group, it will be easier to distribute the work. Okay? And at every course, try to avoid groups where everyone or most of the people are not good at programming. No? So people from outside the ACT are good contributions. I think they are important for the course, having different points of view on the same stuff, not just coding, coding, coding. But try to mix in the different groups in order to have sufficient development capabilities in every group. And once you created the group, you can start thinking about ideas and tell us about them. Suggestions are starting sooner than later. You see, the real implementation will start in May. But there's a lot of work to do before of learning and trying and starting to study something and so on. So you'll find that May and June will fly very fast and try to start earlier, okay? We know that most of the work always piles up in the last weeks, but in the last weeks when you're tired, when the system is really complex and something is not working, it will be very, very stressful for you. So if you try to anticipate them and work in little steps, don't do everything at the end, don't create the different components and try to put them together only on the last day. Try to create a system that does something, small thing, and then increase on that. And having always a working system that every day, every week will do something more, incremental development. Otherwise, you will crash. Don't aim too high. It's very easy at the beginning when you are presenting your ideas to come up with great ideas. Fancy, with a lot of features, capabilities, and it's great. But the issue is that you're not just telling them. You are committing to developing them. So we will, in many cases, we are trying to calm you down and say, okay, but this is not essential, this is not important, try to focus on this. It's better to have a very good, a very well-working project focused on four features rather than have project with 12 different features that don't work very well, because it will be a mess. Nobody will like it. Try to be focused on a small set of features and maybe working on a modular way. So in a way that you can add one feature later if you have more time. Or if something turns out to be easier to do, okay, you can add it later. But always start with something small that works, and then maybe add. Ask, discuss with us, with your friends, with the people outside the course. Try to present your ideas to other people, asking for feedback. And the most difficult part of discussing with others is listening. It's not telling your idea. You will be very happy to tell everybody about your idea, about what you're doing. But they will reply something, and you need to listen. So it's always easy to be convinced of what you said. And something is harder to understand that some people don't see how the way we see a given feature. They see something as useless, or they see something as difficult to use. And if we learn to listen to others' feedback, we will improve our project. First of all, our feedback. Okay, we spend time in giving you feedback, and many times we see that people just don't care. Okay, we are fine. But at the end, the project probably will have some failures. Okay. And exploit the hours in the lab. That we try to spend and give you more as much time as possible in the lab. So try to exploit that. Okay. In the closing of today, what I wanted to do is also to give you some examples of the type of projects that were done in the last years, in the last 2 years mainly. And the last 2 years, we have these two different topics. The first one in 2015, so the year 2014-15, the topic was the smart campus of the university, the Cittadella Politecnica. So the students had to create projects that could improve in some way some space inside the Polytechnic. So they worked on classrooms, they work on navigating, finding things in the university, they work on bathrooms, they worked on study rooms, they work on offices, and so on, thinking about different types of projects. And last year, the topic was health and well-being. So people about with illnesses, people with disabilities, people for doing sport, for managing anxiety, for managing pregnant women, for what was there? Yes, for the allergies to the different pollens and something like that. So there were different projects about all these types of topics. And what I will describe you are the winner projects. So the project that won the prizes at the showcase. So as I said, the rule is that every project that passes the exam can come and present their work at the showcase. I don't care if it's an 18 or a 30 score. Every project who has passed the exam, for me, is a good project and it's eligible to be shown. And at the showcase, the projects are voted by the public. So the public will give votes to the different projects, and the three projects that get the highest number of scores from the public, which is completely unrelated from the score you get at the exam, okay, they win a prize. The prize that is given by a sponsor, by sponsor companies. For example, last year, one of the prizes was an Apple TV for each of the people in the group, so four of them for the group. Another project was, I don't know if you know, the Sonos speakers, hi-fi speakers, and so on. So devices of, prizes of that type, so quite good. And I would have liked to have one, but the sponsor didn't give me. They only gave you. So at the end, the three best projects who pass the exam and who present themselves well at the showcase win some prizes. And these are the winners of the year 2015. I just tell you some words about what they did, so that you can maybe inspire your ideas or think about the kind of projects. This first one, the winner was the project called Marco Poli. And it was a system for helping people navigating or finding things inside the Politecnico. So you come to the Politecnico, you somewhere are lost, you don't know where to go. And so it combines a map system for navigating the internal of the corridors and finding the classroom and so on. And this is the easy part. But also has some sensors about crowded places. So you say don't go in the corridor of the room 246 because there are a million people there, and try to avoid that. Or there is something, maybe some promotion at the library, and so maybe you should go there, or there's some discount at the bar or whatever. Okay. So it gave you information about real-time situation of the corridors and about special events, positive or negative, where to go or to avoid, that took place in the Politecnico. So they had a noise sensor in different parts. Of course, there was during the demo there was only one sensor. We don't need to do a full-scale demo for having the work. We only have a corner that simulates the whole building, and the mobile application that will drive the user. The second project was Well Cleaned. Well Cleaned is a project about the bathroom, and it has a set of sensors that could measure whether the toilet paper was full or empty, whether the soap were full or empty, or whether the litter bin was empty or full. And in the bad case, it could automatically alert the maintenance people to come and refill the soap or the toilet paper, or to empty the paper bin. And at the same time, students could see on the map where the closest bathrooms were, and what were their status. Okay, are they in good status or not? So I don't need to go there and to find that everything is a mess, and so on. And students could also signal something, that something was broken or so. So again, combining some interaction with the user, combining some sensing about the environment, and combining some action, so providing information, calling maintenance, and so on. This third place of 2015 was My Bike Place project, which is a project about parking the bike inside Polytechnic. Remember, the topic of this year was the campus. So you can, you park your bike, and when the wheel of the bike goes onto the sensor, it's registered, And so the device will record the number of the bike, and will remind you, first will remind you where you parked it. So at the evening when you come out, where did I park my bike? And the device can tell you in which stall it was parked in the morning. And additionally, if somebody tries to get the bike before, so the sensor will be open and will alert you during the classroom. You give, you will get a notification about your bike is being stolen right now, and and so you can run. And but at the same time, it knows about which stalls are free and which are occupied, and so you can direct you when you are biking to the Politecnico, say, okay, don't go there because it's already full. Go the other way because there are still places and so on. So this was the idea. Again, sensing something about the position of the bike, your position in the classroom, giving notification, interacting, giving information, and so on. So the main ingredients are the same. Of course, the kind of projects are completely different. And in the 2016, so last year, these are the three winner projects. So the first project was, so the topic of the year were health and well-being, so in general. The first project was Safety Mama. Safety Mama was a project for pregnant women, expecting a baby, that may have some moments of stress or fatigue or something like that. So it's a system that will help them to relax, basically. So it has a sort of a heart rate sensor, you know, all the bracelets that you can use for sports. So the application on the mobile could monitor the heart rate, and when something was too stressful, the heart rate was too high, suggested the person to go to a relaxing corner. And in the relaxing corner, it was a game of lights and music and scent, so perfume in the air, that helped the people calm down and relax. And the cycle, the relaxing cycle, lasted until the heart rate went down again, because one of the problems of pregnant women is getting too high pressure in the blood, and that will be bad. So always good to keep a good shape of health in this case. You can see that, for example, in these projects, the students had to seek help outside. So what are the problem, or the physical problem, or the medical problem for a pregnant woman? So they asked about some doctor, they found some doctors, some friends, and so on, that could give them information. So don't just try to assume that, oh, this idea, and it should be good. Now try to validate it. Okay, this idea, for developing the idea, I need the technical knowledge. Yes, of course, but I also need some domain knowledge. Knowledge about the domain in which I am applying the project. So talking to people. The second project, emergency cast, is about elderly people with Alzheimer or similar diseases. So people in their house that are in some way monitored by the system. And what the system does is two or three things. First is remind people. If you forget to take your medicine, or you forget to have lunch or something like that, it will remind you by flashing some lights in the house. Second is keeping you away from dangerous area of your house. So with proximity sensors, when the person went walking towards the, for example, the fire, it will tell you, no, stay away. There will be a voice message saying, stay away, this is dangerous, don't come here, and so on. So helping people staying aware from dangerous corners of the house, thanks to the proximity detection. And also tracking the person outside the home. So if the person with Alzheimer or some form of dementia left home and went for a walk, then some caregivers, some family member, will be alerted, saying, okay, the person left the house, and with GPS, they gave some approximate position about where the person was. So sort of sensing a person. This person will not be the main person interacting with the system, because in this case it's a sort of passive monitoring and active messaging, trying to modify the behavior of a person to make it safer. The third one, Study Station is more hardware oriented as a project. It's a t-shirt. You see that in the back of this t-shirt there are two small circuits, and these circuits contain accelerometers and gyroscopes to understand, to measure the position of your back. Okay, so if while you are if you are studying in a wrong position, if you are tilting too much or you're bending too much or something like that, so that will be in the long term bad for your back, the system will tell you. So if you wear this t-shirt, the system will ensure that you always stay in the safest position. So this kind of work was more, again, on creating a sensor. In the other cases, the sensors were already used, a bracelet, a proximity sensor, something that was already off the shelf. In this case, the students, they created a sensor, and they did a lot of signal processing, try to find the right information. They had to consult with a professor working here at Politecnico, who is an expert on ergonomy, to understand what kind of measure to take, because he cannot just invent them or make them out. And at the end, there are a very simple alerting system saying, OK, you are sitting in a wrong position, so try to correct yourself, and so on. So you see, the technologies are more or less the same. Some sensors, some Raspberry, some computer, and some actuators, lights, or notifications, or something opening or closing, or switching on, switching off. But of course, they are applied in a million different ways, depending on specific application goal. So this is what we are trying to do also this year with sustainability. So the idea of sustainability is very wide. As I mentioned, it's about energy, it's about water, is about waste, is about food, is about I've then written down, I don't remember, there are four, five or six different categories that are inside the big topic of sustainability. So try to imagine something useful to do that will help, you see, all these projects help people while they are doing something, while they are moving inside Politecnico, while they are going to the bathroom, while they are parking or finding their bike, while they are having, they are expecting a baby, while they are leaving their house, and while they are studying. So it's not something, it's not an application on the smartphone that you open it and you do that for the sake of itself. It's something that will help you while you are doing something normal in a given environment, and will help you to be more sustainable, will give you hints, will give you warnings if you do something wrong, and will maybe automate some of what you do. I don't know. Probably it will be very difficult to separate the litter automatically, so don't think about that. And but a lot of other stuff can be done. Of course, try to think about a project that can be done by your energies in the March, April, May, and part of June, so 3 months, or something more than 3 months' time. So don't think about too complex stuff that cannot be done, but try to identify some of these possible moments in your life where you can improve some aspect of sustainability. By the way, on Thursday we'll see what are the main attributes, the characteristics of an ambient intelligence project. We will see that there will be 4 steps and 6 features, which are these 6 ones. And we saw that the different projects, some of them were more on the sensing part, some were more on the responsive, so on the proactive part. Some were more or less intelligent, some were more or less transparent. We will define them. Transparent means you don't see the computer. You don't need to interact explicitly with a computer, because the environment itself will be intelligent. You don't need to touch on a computer, something like that. So different projects stress more or less some of the good characteristics, the good features that we want in an embedded intelligence system. It's normal. We cannot do well everything, or you know, have a focus on everything. So if the project is well focused, it will touch most of these features, but exploit more some of them much more deeply than the others. Okay, I think for today we are done. We are 10 minutes ahead. We'll never up again, probably, to be ahead. So I have time if you want for some questions. Okay, so we have time for dinner. Thank you. We see you all on Thursday.